Well, since my baby left me, well, I found a new place to dwell. Well, it's down at the end of Lone Street, that heartbreak hotel where I'll be just so lonely, baby. Well, I'm so lonely. I'll be just so lonely, I could die.
Whenever Elvis was feeling lonely, he always had a place to dwell. In Waco at 2807 Lasker, a place where he could always expect a warm welcome and a home-cooked meal. Eddie Fadal, a longtime friend of Elvis, even built a room on the right side of his Waco home that was custom designed with all of Elvis's favorite things. His daughter Janice remembers it well.
It used to be one of those little drive-through things, you know, like a carport that the old houses had on the side, but my dad closed it in shortly after he met Elvis because he wanted a little den there and we didn't have a den. So my dad closed it in and he built bookshelves all along one wall and put a big stereo in there and always had cigars in there for Elvis, his favorite type of cigar. And he decorated the room all in pink and black because those were Elvis's favorite colors at the time. And he put like this little black and white carpet in there and all the cabinets and bookshelves were painted the pink and black, and he even found some glasses that were the same color and decorated with that. And he put pictures of Elvis up in there that Elvis had given him, and all the little things that he had collected, you know, by being with Elvis, he put in that room and just made it a really special place.
Memories pass between the pages of my mind.
Janice says her father first met Elvis while he was working as a disc jockey at a radio station in Dallas. But it was on Friday, October 12, 1956, that her father and the rest of the family got to know Elvis on a personal level.
Born through a party in the county jail. The prison band was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard his knocked out jailbird sing. Let it rock. Everybody let it rock.
Elvis was in Waco for a concert at the Heart of Texas Coliseum. Janice still has a copy of the contract from Elvis's concert. He was paid $5,000 for his performance. Advance tickets were $1.50, or $2 at the door. That was the night that Eddie and Elvis became friends.
After the show, my dad went backstage and introduced himself to Elvis and invited him over. Said, why don't you come on over and have a few drinks and meet my family. And so we actually have home movies from that night. They're very, very dark and dim because they're so old. But you can see Elvis in those movies drinking and laughing and having a good time and dancing. He was dancing around. He's sitting in a chair and he's listening to music and he has some white shoes on. And because the video is so dark, about all you can see are these white shoes just moving to the music. And then I'm in there at age two, even though it was really late, my dad woke me up. And I'm dancing around the room, you know, to the music too. So it's really kind of neat because it was the night that my dad met Elvis.
After that night, visits from Elvis became a regular event around the Fadal household. Janice says she remembers that his visits always seemed to be accompanied with excitement.
One day, I think it was a Sunday afternoon, I was sitting at a little table by a window at our house, and I was coloring and playing, and I looked out the window, and this big black Cadillac limousine pulled up, and then another big black Cadillac limousine pulled up behind it. And I knew it was Elvis because he'd been to our house before. And I jumped up from the chair and I ran, you know, to my dad and mom. I said, Elvis is here, Elvis is here. I was running through the house and they weren't prepared to have a visitor. You know, they were like, I don't know, they were just relaxing. It was a Sunday afternoon. All of a sudden here they had probably 8, 10, 12 people descend on the house. And my mom had to suddenly cook for them and, you know, do all these things. So it was really exciting. And I think that's what I remember the most about it, is all the excitement of the adults that surrounded Elvis, because as a child he was just another person.
Oh, baby, they let me be. You love me, take me back.
Now that Janice is an adult, she can appreciate the significance of this person. And she's one of the few that can claim that she sat on Elvis's lap and even received a peck on the cheek. She remembers it well.
Elvis kissed me on the cheek, too, so that's even cooler. I was only 5 years old, but it was really neat in the home movies to go back and see that. And at the time that he did that, it was funny. My mom had just set out this relish tray with pickles and olives and chips and all this kind of stuff on the table in front of him. And he had just started, you know, eating these sweet pickles. He liked these tiny little baby sweet pickles. That was one of his favorite things. And so he had a sweet pickle in one hand, and he's hugging me and kissing me, you know, with his sweet pickle breath at the same time. And so it was really funny. I'll never forget that.
There are other memories that Janice won't forget. She has plenty of mementos to help her recall these precious times, like this hat Elvis once wore to a restaurant in Dallas, and this piano, where Elvis would play his renditions of other artists' music of the day.
And he would go to the piano and sound it out on the piano just enough so that he could play the piano and sing along with it. And we have recordings of him singing different songs that were popular at the time, like Happy Birthday Baby, and I think that was the one he was really stuck on the recording that we have, because I think he sang that about six times. But he would sit at the piano and play, and my dad and Elvis's girlfriend would just kind of come up and try to harmonize with him, and everybody would just sing along, and it was really a lot of fun. And Elvis used to bring his friends over from Fort Hood, and they would all sit in the living room, and Elvis would play the piano for them. So there's a lot of special memories involved with the piano.
Well, get out of that kitchen and rattle those pots and pans. Get out of that kitchen and rattle those pots and pans.
Elvis enjoyed home-cooked meals prepared by Eddie's wife, Linnell. Even with fame, he maintained a taste for good old Southern cooking.
Some of the favorite things that he liked to eat were really basic, plain things, because Elvis grew up a poor boy, and so he had the taste of a poor boy. He was not brought up on steak or anything like that, and pizza was not a big thing back then like it is today, so he grew up on things like beans and cornbread and greens, just real down-home Southern cooking. Bacon, he loved ham and bacon. So when he would come visit, it was really interesting. He would like to eat the beans that were cooking on the stove, and all the guys that came with him wanted steak. So it was really, you know, it was really a dichotomy there, because here's Elvis, the big star that could afford the, you know, the filet mignon, and here's the guys that are with him that, you know, weren't brought up eating the same kind of food that Elvis was, and so they wanted the steaks, and he just wanted the basic stuff.
I'm all shook up. Mm-hmm.
Elvis's visits did shake up the community of Waco. Word would quickly get out that Elvis was once again at the Fadals' home.
So many people in Waco knew that Elvis came to our house. And any time, you know, they would see a different car or a Cadillac or something parked there, people would descend on our house, and they would just stand outside in the street and sit on the yard and just wait to see Elvis. And of course, the reason Elvis came to our house was to get away from that. So he would, you know, sometimes just really want to hide. And we actually had to have our phone number changed and make it unlisted, because we would get so many phone calls when people thought that Elvis was in town.
The Fadals did try to shield Elvis from all the fan frenzy when he was staying at their home. But even in the early days, an Elvis sighting was the talk of the town. Janice remembers one event in particular at the 25th Street Theater.
But my dad knew the manager at the theater. So he called him and he said, you know, your 10 o'clock show, I want to bring a friend of mine. It's Elvis Presley, but please don't let the word get out, because he really wants to keep this low key. So Elvis and my dad and Elvis's girlfriend at the time and my mom all piled in a car, and they went down there. When they got there, of course, the manager had let the word out, and a lot of people were there waiting to see Elvis. So there was a lot of tension there, but he got in the theater, he got a seat, and he watched most of the movie, and I think my mom told me, like during the last 5 or 10 minutes, he just started getting really antsy, because he knew that as soon as the movie was over, people were going to swarm him. And so he really wanted to get out of there. So he leaned over to my dad and said, would you get the car and bring it around to the back? So my dad did that, and when my dad got up, it kind of signaled to the people in the audience that maybe Elvis was getting ready to leave. So they started getting kind of antsy too, and one, you know, person tried to come up to Elvis, and my mom was sitting on the end of the row, and she just put her foot up on the chair, you know, in front of her to block him and keep him from coming in. And when my dad came back in to let him know that the car was back there, the four of them just literally ran out the back door, jumped in the car, and came home.
Some may wonder how a man in Waco became such good friends with a music legend. Janice says her father was truly a man of hospitality.
It could have been, you know, a cultural thing. My dad was Lebanese, full-blooded Lebanese, and a lot of Lebanese people came to Waco and settled. And the Lebanese people just liked to overwhelm their guests with food and hospitality, and you know, just do everything they can to make a person feel welcome. And I think it was part of my dad's culture to do that, and I think Elvis just really enjoyed that, you know. And also my dad gave him a peaceful place to be away from all the hectic things that were going on in his life, like in Fort Hood. And also at the time that we knew him, his mom passed away, and so there were a lot of really hard things that he was going through at that time. And to come to our house and just listen to music and smoke cigars and eat home cooking, it just really meant a lot to him.
Love me tender, love me sweet.
Elvis meant a lot to Eddie too. Eddie followed Elvis's career, accompanying him on many of his tours. When Elvis's mother Gladys died, Eddie offered comfort and even planted this oak tree in his front yard in her memory. When Elvis passed away, Eddie was there to comfort the family.
It was pretty hard. My dad flew up to Graceland, I think, the day that he heard about it, and stayed up there for the funeral.
Sadly, both Elvis and Eddie are alive only in Janice's memories. A stone memorial has been placed in the front yard of the home on Lasker in honor of Elvis. Like many people, Janice prefers to remember Elvis in his earlier days.
It was before the Army. It was before, you know, all the movies that he made. He was really an up-and-coming, rising star. He was the very first big media star, I think, that we had, you know, that the media really made. And he was very much an innocent person then. And I think that's what people like about the early Elvis, is that when he performed, he would do whatever he felt. You know, it was from the heart. And I think later it became more choreographed and more controlled by, you know, the forces that controlled Elvis. And I think that's why people, you know, are really turned on by the old Elvis.
One day, Janice would like to set up a museum to display all her family photos and mementos. But for now, she set up a virtual museum on the internet so other Elvis fans can remember the king of rock and roll.
Of holding hands and red bouquets and twilights trimmed in purple haze and laughing eyes and simple ways and quiet nights and gentle days with you. Memories.